enter Edward Mandel House. Edward Mandel House is attributed with giving a very detailed, write that name down and go and look it up. All these people that keep telling you secure party creditor is not necessary. I'm going to shut it all down. Edward Mandel House is attributed with giving a very detailed outline on the plans to be implemented to enslave the American people. The 13th Amendment in 1865 opened the way for people to volunteer into slavery by accepting benefits offered by the United States. So whether House actually spoke the words or not, it is irrelevant. Because the scenario detail in the statement attributed to him has clearly been implemented. Central banking for the United States was legislated with the Federal Reserve Act of 1913. Write that down. The Federal Reserve Act of 1913. Write down all these things I'm telling you. Come back and prove me wrong. See, that's how I get people, hey, man, you was right. Prove me wrong. See, the ability to decrease the currency in circulation through taxation. Tax season, huh? That's the ability to decrease the currency in circulation through taxation was legislated with the 16th Amendment in 1913. Support for the presumption that the American people had volunteered to participate in the United States democracy was legislated with the 17th Amendment. In what year? You guessed it. 1913. The path was provided for the control of the courts with the creation of the American Bar Association. In what year? You guessed it. 1913. Prove me wrong. Prove me wrong. Fast forward to 1917. The United States legislature passed the Trading with the Enemy Act. The Emergency War Powers Act, opening the doors for the United States to suspend limitations to government authority otherwise mandated in the Constitution. That act gave the government way more control over the people. What do? You set aside, you let it take place just like you do now. Even in times of peace, prepare for war. Because peace doesn't last forever. God tells the dog, so he knows, said it. So even in times of peace, every contrived and created social, political, and financial emergency was sufficient authority for the officers of the United States to overstep its peaceful powers and implement volumes of law that will increase the coffers of the United States. Now remember, every new law starts out as a bill in the House of the Senate. So once this passed, they could identify someone to pay the bill. Let me remind you of Edward Mandel House's words. Go and look this up, folks. I want you to think about this because they say you don't need to be a secure party creditor. And so to all of those people that are saying that, I ask you, how do you get out of this? There's a birth certificate for a reason. Prior to the birth certificate, all his birth was kept in the family Bible, which was considered to be a legal document and still is. And still is. Edward Mandel House said, and by the way, he was Woodrow Wilson's handler. Woodrow Wilson was a president, but Edward Mandel House, from my perspective, was calling the shots. He was a very powerful man. His words. They will mend our house, and very soon every American will be required to register their biological property. What is that talking about? That means your baby. In a national system designed to keep track of the people that will operate under an ancient system of pledging. By such methodology, we can compel people to submit to our agenda, which will affect our security as a chargeback for our fiat paper currency. Every American will be forced to register, or suffer not being able to work and earn a living. They will be our chattel, and we will hold the security entrance over them forever. By operation of law merchant under the scheme of secure transactions, Americans, by unknowingly or unwittingly delivering the bill of lading to us, will be rendered bankrupt and insolvent forever to remain economic slaves through the taxation secured by their pledges. They will be stripped of their rights and given commercial value designed to make us a profit, and they will be none the wiser. For not one man in a million could ever figure out our plans. This is why these guys are saying you don't need to be a secured creditor, because they can't figure out the plans. Well, and if by accident, one or two will figure it out, we have an arsenal plausible deniability. What does that mean? That means if something exists, and you got a lot of people say, oh man, that's not true, you don't have to be no secure party creditor. That means if something exists, they have plausible deniability. They could deny that it even exists. And once they tell you, hey, that's not true, it's frivolous, you believe it, they won. Plausible deniability. After all, it is only logical way to fund government by floating liens and debts and registrants in the form of benefits and privileges. This will inevitably reap to us huge profits beyond our wildest expectations and leave every American a contributor or to this fraud, which we call social insurance. See, when the Social Security first came out, it was called social insurance. It's still called that in Canada. Without realizing it, every American will insure us for any loss we may incur. And in this manner, every American will unknowingly be our servant. However, fraudulently, the people will become helpless and without any hope for their redemption. And we will employ the high office of the president of a dummy corporation. That dummy corporation is the District of Columbia, which I spoke of earlier, to foment this plot against America. End of quote. So said Edward House. Now, there's always a declared emergency, if you notice, folks, in the United States and its states, but it only applies to their subjects. In other words, you must consent. Let's get some donations up on here, man. Let's get some donations in the room, man, for my time and energy. And go ahead and like and share this, man, because I got some treats for you. I'm going to show you how I affect the Blue D bill of exchange, and it works for me every time towards the end of this presentation. Now, in the 1930s, but you need this history to understand why this stuff is essential. Understand that. Now, in the 1930s, the federal legislation provided for registration of babies through the application for birth certificates. So government workers could get maternity leave with pay. That's the reason it came forth with the registration for the birth certificate. The states pushed for registration of cars. Prior to that, you didn't have to register no damn car, man. I bought this car as mine. There's no trust. I had the allodial title.